Well, good evening, fans and viewers of the Malik Show. I'm your host, Malik Shabazz Sullivan, and may I say, how you doing? Fans and viewers, I do have a special guest right now with us, but before we move on, I do have some little bad news. Cheryl Jackson couldn't be with us tonight. She had some things to do. Like I said, I'm not going to put everything out there, but she does send her love and her greetings on tonight, and hopefully soon she will be popping in for our show. Anyway, we do have somebody special. I'm about to introduce someone who does have a singing voice and that can tear the rug up. This young man I've known since the 11th grade. He is a current student at Duval High School, and he serves as the Duval High School Gospel Choirist. And I'm just telling you, as long as I've been knowing him, he is a powerful speaker, and I call him the preacher man. And ladies and gentlemen, I give you now and at this time, Demontre Washington.
Hello, praise God. How are you?
Yes, Demontre, welcome to the Malik Show. I want to thank you for being on the show tonight. And you do not know how you are helping us out due to Cheryl's couldn't be with us tonight. But I do want to say, Demontre, that you do have a voice that God has blessed you with. And like I said, you are going to show our fans and viewers tonight. But first, Demontre, what I want to ask you before you sing your first song on tonight is, how do you feel about music? What does music mean to you?
Music means a lot of things to me. Music means life. Music means love. Music means so many things. You know, when you say music, a lot of things come to mind, especially through the kind of music that I sing. I sing gospel music. And when I think of gospel music, I just think about the Spirit of God and how God has brought me up on so many different things. And music is just so wonderful, you know. When I think of music, I think of different colors, depending on how high the pitches are when I sing. And, you know, so many things come to mind. And music can take you through anything. There's a song for everything. There's a song when you're sad, and a song when you're happy, a song when you're up and when you're down, you know. Music has its way of creeping in on you every now and then, and just helping you out in any aspect of life. That's what I love about music, and that's what music means to me.
Yes, indeed. Demontre, if you can just speak up just a little bit and clearly, then we would be all right.
All right, can you hear me now?
Wonderful, perfect. I hear you just fine. But I'm glad that music is good to you. Now, Demontre, this is another interview question I want to ask you. Demontre, you are a current Duval High School student.
Yes, I am.
You do sing in the choir. And what I want to ask this is, how do you feel that, you know, how do you feel singing in the Duval High School Gospel Choir?
Well, one, I feel very, 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 very honored to be under the leadership of Mr. Damon P. Gray. He's a wonderful director, and he just loves to magnify and glorify God, and that's one thing we have in common. I just love being a part of it. It's a wonderful thing to get to travel and sing with the folks that I love, singing gospel choir and classical music. We have a wonderful, wonderful CDI called Use Me. You should check it out. Do that gospel choir. It's wonderful, and it'll just bless your spirit. I just love to be our family. I love you all.
Yes. That is good, Demontre, that you have said that. Mr. Gray, ladies and gentlemen, if you all do not know who he is the Duval High School music teacher. He has been serving as the teacher since I've been there since 2007, but probably more than that. But I do want to say that he is an inspiration to lots of people. Demontre, second of all, you are right. The Duval High School High School Gospel Choir does have a CD out, and I've listened to it, and you all are just fantastic, and you know, that is real good. But Demontre, here's the last question before we let you sing your first song. I want to ask about Judgment, and I want to ask about Hypocrite. As in, you know, Demontre, you do have a good singing voice, but how do you feel when people judge you and say, oh, or you might hear about it from, you know, maybe the other choir members or friends of yours that, oh, you can't sing, you can't do this, you can't do it. How do you feel when you hear about that negative energy?
Well, actually, what I do is I take that negative energy and I turn it around, because I know that I serve a God that can look beyond my faults and see my every need. So, you know, I don't really worry about too much, because all power lies within the Savior's hand. So I don't really look at the negative aspect. I mean, you know, people get into their ways, but, you know, God is able to do a whole lot of things. So I don't even, you know, think about that thing. You know, the Bible says, if God before me, who can come against me? So therefore, you know, my mind immediately goes to the cross, and I stay high behind the cross. Because if I stay high behind the cross, you know, I got a pledge also. But, you know, I just try to work around it, and God is still good. So.
That's right. That's right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, like I said before, for Demontre sings his first song, Cheryl Jackson couldn't be with us tonight, but she does send her greetings and remarks to the show and to you all. But I just thank God for sending Demontre and for him saying yes. I really appreciate that. But ladies and gentlemen, as I said last night, it's not about me this week. These are about these performers, these singers, these artists this week. So the spotlight is off me. Demontre, at this time, you may sing your first song. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mr. Demontre Washington.
Thank you, thank you. My first selection would be His Eyes Are the Sparrow. When all hope is lost and everything seems to be drowning down in the dumps, I know that God is still watching over me. Why should I be discouraged? And why should the shadows come? And why should my heart be lonely? Love for my heavenly home. When Jesus saves my portion, a constitution is He. And that His eye is on the throne, and I know that He watches over me. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Wow, that was, and you know what, Demontre, you know what's funny, and I wasn't going to say anything, but I, like I said, you did a good job. Sequoia on last night has sang the same song that you have just sang just now. Yes, that is a powerful, powerful song. Well, since you have sung your first, like I said, we're going to get on with the interview, and we will get to your second part of the song. Now, Demontre, this is what I want to ask, and I asked this to Sequoia last night. How do you feel when the generation, our generation, the youth, listens to such foul and nasty music, such as Beyonce's Freakum Dress, Lil Wayne, Lollipop, or I'm trying to think of another song that is so vile to our youth generation that gets, you know, us pumping. Oh, yeah, and it's another song. I can't think of it. But what I want to ask Demontre is, how do you feel that we are listening to negative music versus we should be listening to music like, you know, Smokey Norful or Marvin Sapp or Chris Brown, that kind of stuff.
Well, how I feel about it is basically, you know, God makes different types of genres, you know, but we as a generation, we've taken our eyes off what really matters, which is, you know, God. Even though, you know, it's so many different genres of music, but we put our eye on the negative side. And, you know, I had a woman say to me the other day, you know, she said to me, she said, this generation does not know Jesus. And when I was manifesting in my spirit, I was just like, you know what? That's right. A lot of us, we do not know Jesus. You know, I feel that if that degrading music, you know, it should be less of that, you know, because my mother, she always says, well, you guys don't really know music. And, you know, it's true, because when I listen to some of her songs, you know, they're all love songs and everything, but they have a meaning behind it. And not the songs nowadays, they have meanings behind it, but they have meaning that influencing us to be older than what we really are. And it takes our mind to another dimension, which is really, really, really discouraging. You know, I would hate for me to have kids in the future and they're just growing up off of the negativity of what this world has to offer, you know. So, how I feel about it, I feel that it's sad, you know. It's nothing we can really do other than pray to God to make a way, you know. But people are going to do what they want to do. So, until then, you know, there's not much I can do. But personally, I feel that we just keep taking our eyes off the real music and just backtrack another way.
That's right. Here is something else that has been brought up to my attention on tonight when I was scavenging over the internet. And I know, and you know what, DeMontre, here's a thing. I know you into church and all, and so am I. But I was reading about Steve Harvey and Donnie McClurkin. And I was looking about how Steve Harvey talked about how the church today are discouraging a lot of youth. You know, their main talk was about the church, but the main thing I want to put into that little box is the youth. How the church discourages the youth. They talk about the youth as in, you know, we're degenerates, how we're nothing compared to the adults. You know, they're everything. But what I want to say, DeMontre, is how do you feel when the church gets involved in the youth's dreams and discourages and all that kind of stuff?
Well, how I feel about that portion, there's a lot I could really say about that. You know, God, the church is supposed to be saving souls and delivering and having these little disciples for Christ. And when adults, they run the youth away from the church, there's not much that, you know, that the church will be able to do, you know, because this generation right here is growing bigger and bigger every day, and they're the future, not just the future of today, but the future of tomorrow and next week and the week after that. We're the future, so therefore our churches will grow off of what we teach our children. And if we teach our children how to be fake in the church house, they will grow up as a generation, and the church will go sinking. And that's the last thing I would want for a church as a generation to sink, you know. And I feel that they should use the children to the fullest ability instead of running away from the church, because there's so much about the little children unto me, you know. And I feel that there's so much that a child can do in the Christian community, in the church, you know. So many things that children can do as far as youth choir and step teams and usher. There's so many things that God has for this generation to do that, you know, is so much. It's just so much to handle right now, you know, as far as certain kids, you know. But the only thing that we can do for the ones that are saved, you know, is pray for the ones that are lost. And hopefully, through our prayers and us clinging together and talking to God, we can tag somebody else along with us and do this thing together as a generation and build up the kingdom of God. As far as other saints, seasonal saints in Christ, all you got to do is look up to the angel which comes to your help. Because when I'm standing there with Jesus, it's not going to be me, the person that destroys me, and Jesus. It's going to be me and Jesus. So I got to learn how to work around it as a Christian, as a babe in Christ, growing up in Christ. I got to learn for myself how to, you know, just trust God and know that it's my life really in His hand. Everything is taken care of.
Yeah. You are absolutely right about that. Now, Demontre, here is one last thing before we have a little break, and this and the break is going to be tomorrow's preview. I want to ask this. We do have lots and lots of people that is into go-go. Now, I know you and I know about go-go, but how do you feel when go-go terrorizes and affects people's lives?
I just feel personally that, you know, that right there, that in itself has taken over at least 80% of our youth today. And I don't like it. I don't like the fact that music has, that kind of music has taken over. You know, it's discouraging, and that's not what we want our generation to grow up off of. But, you know, honestly, it is what it is, and children will be children. And, you know, local music, not all of it is bad. You know, from back in the day, it was pretty good. It was a party thing, but now people are tearing up our community with this wacky music, and they're taking it into different places and CFEs and go-go's. They're even making go-go's really huge to the point they're having it at stadiums now and selling out houses. I mean, thousands and thousands of kids coming from any and everywhere just to hear these go-go bands and paying all of this money just to listen to this racket and all this confusion banged into their head. You know, I feel personally that I personally do not promote it. I would not promote it, and I pray that God would just, it will be a miraculous change in this generation. I just pray for the future to be shaped to be so much better. Because right now, it's not looking too good.
It's not is. Well, fans and viewers, right now we're going to take a short 60-second break. We're going to view tomorrow's show, and when we come back, Demontre will sing his second song.
But I ain't there to stop living. I won't pretend I'm good at giving. But I can't hate you, though I have tried. I still really, really love you. Ooh, love is stronger than pride. I still really, really love you.
Okay, welcome back. That was a preview of tomorrow's show. Demontre and I should know this person very well. Gerard Cook will be live with us on tomorrow. He is the guest for tomorrow's show.
Yeah.
Yes, indeed. But yes, Demontre, you have shared some great, honest comments. And, you know, it is very sad that the youth, the generation that we are in and living with, are terrorizing and messing up the music. So, hopefully that, you know, it will be a change in the later future. But Demontre, at this time, I'm going to let you sing your second song. I hope that this last song is kind of long because you sure have tore the first one up. So, ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mr. Demontre Washington again.
Praise God. This second song is called It Is Good With My Soul. There's so many things in this life that just tear our spirits down, but there's still a God that I serve that is so worthy, and do whatever it is that you're going through, God can work it out, all right? Pray in peace like a river, attending my way. When souls like these barrels swell, oh Lord, whatever my life, it has taught me to say, it is well with me.
Captioning and other considerations for the Malik Show is provided by closed captioning. All right. I'm telling you, fans, so far, this music is real weak. It's going by real good. Last night, we had Sequoia, and tonight, we have Demontre. Demontre, you are truly God's gift and blessing. And, you know, don't ever let nobody, and hear me when I say it, don't let nobody discourage you or tell you what you can and you cannot do, because God is real and he's on the cross. He died for our sins, and we just thank him every day, you know. But this music is real weak. It's truly a blessing, and I just thank God. Demontre, at this time, we're getting close to closing, so I will let you. Now, if you want, you can have a closing song. But first, I would like for you to have your closing remarks and your shout-outs.
All right, at this time, I would just like to just thank God, first of all, who is ahead of my life and who is in control of everything that I say and that I do. And I would just like to thank God for the Duval High School. I want to thank every choir member and every supporter. First of all, I want to thank God for my mom and my dad and my, you know, just my brothers and sisters. You know, I pray that everybody just pray for me. You know, these are the hard times in life, you know what I'm saying? Life's getting really, really hard. I pray for God, but everybody just pray for me. I like to shout out all of my loving friends. Amen. You know who you are. I just want to thank God for you. Thank God for keeping you a perfect health and keeping you around. I just want to thank God, just to be thanking God, because he's worthy of all the praise and worthy of everything that I have to offer unto him. I just want to bless God for all the many people that will be listening to this broadcast, that will be blessed by this broadcast, and I pray that you've taken something that I've said on tonight and just reflect it to your life or share it with someone, that somebody else may be blessed in the process. Give a hand and drag somebody along with you throughout this Christian race, because it's a blessing, and it's a blessing to be a blessing. And then being a blessing, when the places go up, the blessings come down. So when you help somebody else, hopefully they'll want to help somebody else, so we can make this generation a better generation. And I just want to just say, God is good, and His mercy endures forever. And His truth is always true. So just trust God with all your heart. Lead not to your own understanding. And just know that God is real. He's sitting on the throne, and He loves you. And I love you also. Bless God.
Yes, indeed. Well, Demontre, I thank you for being on the Malik Show tonight. Be sure the video will be posted on Facebook so you can share it with whoever you want to share it with or whoever. But I really, really appreciate and thank you for being on the show tonight.
Thank you so much.
Yes, and I will talk to you soon. God bless you and be true and be you.
Amen. God bless you all. Thank you.
All right, then. Take care. Bye-bye.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Demontre Washington, a good friend of mine from Duval High School. He has served as a member of the Duval High School Gospel Choir. He has also been doing a lot of activities around the school, but I thank God for having him sing and perform right here live on the Malik Show. You all just don't know how overwhelmed I am that this week so far, even though I know it's Tuesday, but it, like I said, since last night, I just really felt good in my spirit. So I just thank God for having people saying yes and having people that is worthy to do it. So I thank you. Fans, tune in tomorrow night, Wednesday, April 14th. Gerard Cook, who is also another Duval alumni and choir member, will be with us tomorrow night live on the Malik Show. And Thursday, fans, remember the show's line and the Skype will be open for your entertainment and for your enjoyment, so you will have the chance to Skype or call in the show. And if you've been watching, I hope that you all will give me some good comments on our performers. Last night was Sequoia Shuler, and tonight was Demontre Washington. I apologize for Cheryl Jackson's absence, but hopefully she will have an upcoming request or may be coming on our show later in the year. I thank you all for being on the show, watching the show tonight. And the quote of the show is, "Don't be blessed." I said, don't be stressed, just be blessed. That's what I wanted to say. Be true, be you. God bless you.